is a difference in density. Okay, so when there is a difference of density, the one of the methods that we use is known as decantation. Now, in decantation, what do we do is we take the mixture, decantation, one end. Okay, theek hai? We take the mixture in whatever beaker or anything. Okay, and this mixture, we put it out here. So the mixture is out here. And what happens is the solid particles are going to settle down. The more dense particles rather. The particles that are more dense will settle down. And when the particles that are more dense settle down, what can we do is we can pour it off. And when we pour it out, the lighter particles come here and the denser particles stay where it is. That is known as decantation. This is known as what? Decantation. My video is on or off? It's off, right? Okay, now. The next one, in this only, what you can do is, you can use filtration. Now, the second process, if you look at filtration, in filtration, what do we have is, in filtration, we take a funnel, okay? So we have the funnel out here, and in the funnel, we put the filter paper. So the filter paper is taken like this. The filter paper is basically a circle, okay? So what do we do is one fold, two folds, and then we open it up. When we open it up from one of the side, it resembles a cone. So we put that cone here, and slowly we put the mixture here. When we pour the mixture here, what happens is the solid particles get stuck out here in the filter paper. The solid particles cannot pass through. When the solid particles cannot pass through, the one which is the liquid, it passes through and you can separate it like this by filtration. Okay? Okay, now when the filtration is done, then there is another one. Another method is known as hydraulic washing. Now, again, hydraulic washing also uses the concept of difference in densities. We take the crushed mixture, and put it out here. And then we have a sloping part which has cup-shaped things like this out here. Now, when we are going to wash it with water, everything is going to flow down. The denser particles, the mixture, this is the mixture, okay? We are washing the mixture with water. Okay? And then the lighter particles keep on flowing down like this. And the heavier particles settle down out here. And finally, the lighter particles are coming here and going out. So in this way, we were able to separate both the things. Okay? So the three methods that we saw are what? Decantation, filtration, and right. Now, one more, in which we have what? A colloidal particle. Okay? When you have a colloidal particle, okay, a colloidal particle passes through the filter paper. So you cannot use this method. So in a colloidal, when you have colloid, we use the process of centrifugation. We have the liquid, okay, like let's say milk. Now, milk contains milk protein and milk fat. Milk contains milk protein and milk fat. Okay? Now, this is in the colloidal phase. So, when we shake it, centrifugate it, matlab when we rotate it very fast, the process is known as centrifugation. So, when we are going to rotate it very fast, what happens is the milk protein and the fat are going to separate and they are going to form a lower layer. Now, if your mama makes butter at home, you'll see the same process being used. You'll see that the liquid part separates out, and that is nothing but what? Centrifugation. Take care. Clear? This one is clear? Now when we have to separate immiscible liquids. Now, what are immiscible liquids? They are liquids which are what? Do not mix with each other. So, for this type of a thing, we take a separating funnel. A separating funnel is somewhere like the shape, okay? A shape of a thing that is used to, you know, scare the, used for music for that. What do we call? The snakes. The snake charmers use something like this. Okay? Now we have the liquid, okay? Now, immiscible liquids form two different layers. So, they are the two different layers of immiscible liquid. We open the tap. The tap is opened, okay? And the denser liquid is going to flow out. Now, when the denser liquid ka layer reaches the tap, we just close the tap. So what happens is the denser liquid has flowed out and gets collected outside, and the heavier, lighter liquid that is there, the green one gets collected in the funnel. In this way, we have separated two, what kind of liquid? Immiscible liquids. Take care? Now, if we have to separate mixtures, a mixtures of solid, I have already done two ways. We can use hydraulic washing. Take care? We can use hydraulic washing. We can use filtration. We can use decantation. One more is there. If there is a difference in the magnetic properties, one of the substances is magnetic in nature and the other substance is non-magnetic in nature. Then what do we do is we put it out here. There are two wheels. One wheel is a magnet. The other wheel is a non-magnet. Theek hai? Now, on top of this, we have a conveyor belt. Okay. Now, on the conveyor belt, we are going to place the mixture. Now, the mixture is placed out here. What will happen is, as soon as you start rotating the wheel, okay, the thing that sticks to the magnet would come to this point, and the thing that does not stick to the magnet will stick to the wheel only till here. So this part is going to fall down here. The non-magnetic substance is going to fall out here, and the magnetic substance is going to fall like this out here, and we get two different heaps, and in this way we separated a magnetic substance and a non-magnetic substance. Theek hai? Now, if there are two solids who have different kinds of solubility, they have a difference in solubility. Theek hai? Now, when you have a difference in solubility, let's say, a solid A that is soluble in water, but a solid B is insoluble in water. So what are we going to do is, if it is present in a beaker, the mixture is present in a beaker, we are going to place it out here and we are going to add water to it. So the mixture was there, okay? We poured in water. And we'll stir it. When we stir it, A will dissolve. Okay. B will not dissolve. Now, after this, what we are going to do is, we are going to do filtration again. So the second step would be filtration. Now, when we are doing the filtration of air, what will we get is on the funnel. On the funnel, we will get the insoluble part. The insoluble part will be here. And the soluble is going to flow down and get collected in a beaker. Now, what are we going to do? After it is getting collected in the beaker, upar wala to we are just going to dry it and we are going to get the B part of it. Niche wala, we will do a crystallization or evaporation and we are going to get the A part also, either by crystallization or evaporation. So we separated two solids which have a difference in their solubility. Okay? Now we come to two liquids which are miscible. Okay? What are miscible liquids? Exactly. Okay. Let's say we have alcohol and water. Okay? We have alcohol mixed in water. Now we want to get the alcohol back and water back. So we are going to use the normal distillation. In normal distillation, there should be a difference in boiling point. Okay. Now, I don't know how much it is given in your book, but generally the difference in boiling point should be 10 degrees C to 20 degrees C. Okay. Now, I'll explain it simply without making a diagram. Okay. Let's say we have a mixture of A and B. A boils at 100 degrees C, B boils at an 80 degrees C. Theek hai? Now I take both of them and I heat them to 90 degrees C. Now if I heat them to 90 degrees C, which is going to form vapor and go up, rise up? B is going to rise up. Okay, now then we pass it through a condenser. Where it gets liquefied. Okay, and B will be collected here. A will be left behind. So in this way, we separated two miscible liquids which had a difference in their boiling point. That is approximately 10 degrees to 20 degrees C ka difference in their boiling point. Theek hai? But what do we do if we have something like petroleum? Theek hai? In a petroleum, it is a mixture of a lot of things. Kerosene, gasoline, okay, diesel, natural gas, paraffin wax. So many different things are there. Now, for this type of a thing, we use a fractionating column. Okay? In a fractionating column, what do we see is, let's say, let's write it down like this, ki A has 100 degrees C boiling point, B has 110 degrees C, 120 degrees C, 130 degrees C, and 140 degrees C. Theek hai? Now I have my A, B, C, D, E and I heat it up to 135 degrees C. Theek hai? Kis cheez ka vapor banke upar jayega and what are the things that will not form vapor? Will form vapor, rises up. E gets left behind, which can be collected here. Theek hai? So now we have what? Now we have an A, B, C, D. Now, when it is rising up, it would lose energy. Theek hai? If it loses energy out of A, B, C, and D, which is going to attain its boiling point first? Which one is going to liquefy first? वाई ए, देखना 135 है, ऊपर जा रहा है, एनर्जी का लॉस हो रहा है, तो 135 से 134 डिग्रीज, 133 डिग्रीज, 132 डिग्रीज, एग्जैक्टली 130 डिग्रीज. सो दिस वन इज गोइंग टू लिक्विफाई एंड इट इज गोइंग टू गो अप. बट वेपर्स ऑफ ए बी एंड सी आर स्टिल गोइंग अप. ठीक है, अब ऊपर जा रहा है, इट इज लूजिंग मोर एनर्जी. सो नाउ विच वन इज गोइंग टू लिक्विफाई? सी इज गोइंग टू लिक्विफाई. सो सी इज कलेक्टेड इन अ सेपरेट कॉलम. ओके, नाउ वेपर्स ऑफ ए एंड बी आर स्टिल गोइंग अप. ओके, नाउ विच वन इज गोइंग टू लिक्विफाई? बी इज गोइंग टू लिक्विफाई. सो बी कैन बी कलेक्टेड. ओके, एंड फाइनली the vapors of A are collected. So this is the same way in which we do the separation of petroleum. In petroleum, we do the same way. ठीक है, we collect the paraffin wax and mobile oil etc. as E. Then as we keep on going up, according to the boiling point, everyone is collected, the petroleum, the diesel, the kerosene. And finally, on top, we collect the petroleum gas. ठीक है, so this is what, this is our fractionating column. ठीक है, and the last type, if we have to separate colored pigments generally, we use a technique known as what? Chromatography. ठीक है, now the simplest chromatography is the paper chromatography. ठीक है, have you done paper chromatography? Right, we take a small piece of paper and then we mark a line out here and then we place a drop of colored pigment, ink or anything out here, and the tip is held on the solution and the solution rises. And once the solution rises, what happens is we see different colors separating at different points of the chromatography paper. So in this way, we were able to separate the different colored pigments. Okay, but chromatography can be used in other way methods also. We can have a burette. Okay, in a burette, we prepare a chromatographic column. And in this burette, what will we have is a gelatin, a gel-like material with adsorbent in it. Now, when we place the mixture out here, the mixture is going to be placed out here and the suitable liquid is to be dropped over it. Now, this mixture is going to go down, down, down. And the adsorption would start taking place. And different parts of the mixture would get adsorbed at different parts of the column. ठीक है, so this is how we separated mixture by chromatography. ठीक है, so this is what separation of the substance. ठीक है, this is clear. Now the purity and identity of the substances are there, in which we have already done the numerical. Remember, concentration, the purity, how much pure is it? Yes. Okay. So they are talking about that only, the purity and the identity of the substances. If you look at figure 2.18 on page number 33. Okay, so you have the chromatographic paper, you have the fine tube for spotting samples onto the paper, then what happens is you place it in a solvent. Take it, it rises up and then the paper is taken out and put into a locating agent. Then the thermometer raises the temperature and we can see the level reached by each solvent. Okay, and then what we can do is we can use on page number 32 the RF, distance moved by the substance divided by distance moved by the solvent front. Okay, and that in that way we can find out the purity and of the substance as well as the identity of the substance. Take care. So this is separation. I'm stopping this video so that you know it will be easier when you study. If you have to study only separation, you can study on this.